Bigger Thomas has been considered one of the most controversial characters in literature since Native Son was first published. Some critics saw him as a brilliant and powerful personification of reality that Americans needed to recognize. Others saw him as a crude stereotype who perpetuated the dehumanization of African Americans in art and in life.
Through a stereotypical characterization of Bigger, Wright excited his readers' emotions and brought attention to the urban black situation, though his sensationalist style only served to perpetuate the stereotypes he wished to get rid of.
James Baldwin, a literary critic, believed that Wright's novel was authentic. However, he disagreed with White's determining Bigger's identity and believed that Wright only showed part of the truth.
Many critics even claim that Wright glorified the stereotypes of blacks at this time. In The American Other, Mark Rudin Winchell wrote that when black rape is justified on sociological grounds, as in Wright's Native Son, it may go over with the radical chic crowd, but is not likely to play in Peoria.
Winchell suggests that Bigger's characterization doesn't reach an everyday audience as well as he might have intended. Wright may have wanted for the novel to be filled with gritty realism, but the violence and overall undesirable situations offended the delicate sensibilities of the average middle-class American.
Wright's style was also called into question. Robert Butler wrote that some scenes could be misinterpreted by critics as promoting violence, such as when Bigger thinks he had murdered and created a new life for himself, not realizing that the scene is written in third person limited, not in an omniscient point of view. By attempting to justify Bigger's actions, Wright could be seen as justifying other violent acts.
Regardless of whether or not Native Son perpetuated stereotypes, it definitely changed the face of American literature. Irving Howe noted that the novel was a blow to the white man and black man, portraying the white man as an oppressor and showing the black man the cost of his acquiescence. Butler writes that prior to Native Son, urban novels written by white authors did not focus on black people, and there was also an absence in black fiction of realistic descriptions of the lives of urban blacks. Butler explains that Wright's novel is jarring and details the world and lives of blacks living in America's cities.
On an even more serious level, some reviewers question Wright's conception of Bigger Thomas, arguing that the character actually reinforced the brutal stereotypes the author wanted to destroy. Reverend Joseph McSorley argued in Catholic World that Bigger Thomas was a savage moron whose portrayal had the unintended effect of spreading and deepening distrust of the Negro. Jonathan Daniels said that the story of Bigger Thomas is the story of a rat, a dehumanized figure used by the writer to develop his political tract.
Instead of making people reconsider their stereotypes, Bigger's actions in the novel only helped to continue those stereotypes and give Wright shock value when trying to sell his book.
Fellow African-American writer James Baldwin agreed, arguing in his book Many Thousands Gone that it is the climate common to most Negro protest novels, which has led us all to believe that there is no culture common to black life, and Bigger, meanwhile, and all his furious kin serve only to whet the notorious national taste for the sensational, and to reinforce all that we now find it necessary to believe.
What Baldwin says is that novels like Native Son were intended to advance the cause of racial justice for American blacks, but ironically had the reverse effect. These novels were filled with one-dimensional characters who reinforced all the stereotypes that trapped blacks in limited roles. He claimed that Bigger was a monster created by the American Republic, and a social symbol revelatory of social disease, rather than a fully developed, realistic character who could adequately reflect the richness of the African-American experience. Bigger instead came off as uneducated, violent, and narrow-minded, which was unhelpful in relieving the black stereotypes of his age.
So while Wright intended Bigger Thomas to be an eye-opening portrayal of the result of black oppression, a character whose story was so hard and deep that the readers would have to face it without the consolation of tears, the violent, unapologetic monstrosity he created ended up merely reinforcing the racially stereotypical views that many people held at that time. It don't matter if you're black or white.